Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Regent Hall in Plaza Centreville. Please remain standing. Sorry, everyone just sat down. Please remain standing for our national anthem. Thank you, and now everyone can be seated. Okay, we'll get there. There we go. Thank you. It is with great pleasure I welcome you to the 2023 Centennial Regional High School graduation ceremony. Thank you for being present tonight to celebrate the 50th graduation of CRHS. I am Jessie Heron, and it is my honor to be your Master of Ceremonies for this prestigious event. We're very happy that all of you could join us here today. Despite never knowing what the traffic will be like, all the construction, road closures, detours, we have arrived. And everyone's hair still looks great. Despite the rain, a little bit of heat in here, we're all good. So, without further ado, let's get started. Before we begin tonight's ceremony, we must make a few important announcements. Because our students, their families, and their friends deserve the same respect, we want to ensure that every part of this evening's graduation ceremonies is perfect in every possible way. So that there are no distractions, we ask that you turn off all your cell phones and all electronic devices for the duration of this memorable event. At this time, we must state some important messages regarding hotel security. In case of emergency, the Plaza Centreville management asks that you proceed as calmly as possible towards the emergency exits, which are situated at the back of the hall. In the event of a building evacuation, please do not use the elevators, rather use the stairwell located in front of the reception hall and exit by the front doors on the ground floor. On this eventful evening of June 17, 2023, we are gathered to recognize not only the academic achievements, hard work, and dedication of our students, but also the tremendous love, support, and encouragement shown by you, the families and friends of our graduates. As a community, we are very fortunate to have so many loving family members, friends, coaches, mentors, and teachers present today who have significantly impacted the lives of our student body. Every single person in this great hall has the right and the reason to feel successful and to celebrate today. And of course, when we think of memories, we think of cherished pictures and videos. Fortunately, we have a photographer from Studio Nancy to professionally capture precious moments during the diploma presentations on stage. These official photographs will be mailed to the graduates' home over the summer. Just a small note regarding personal photography. We ask that you avoid coming up to the stage to take personal pictures or videos, as your camera flash may affect the quality of the professional pictures being taken on stage. Furthermore, today's graduation is being recorded, and a link to the video will be emailed out and postponed on our, not postponed, posted, on your YouTube channel for all to view, as well as your, as well as ceremony program of awards and bursaries of our winners, which will be posted on our website. That concludes the opening announcements. Thank you for your patience. It is now my pleasure to make some introductions to highlight the presence of some special guests in attendance. Oh, perfect timing. As the introductions are made, I would kindly ask that each group stand and be recognized as a group. May the audience please hold their applause until all members of each group have been introduced. I will begin with the platform party up here on stage, starting on my right. The Director General of the Riverside School Board, Madame Lucy Roy. And the Chairperson of the Council of Commissioners, Mr. Dan Lamareur. Our admin team, Centennial's principal, Ms. Sherry Tite, and Centennial, and Vice Principal, Ms. Amber Coons. Seated in our audience, we are privileged to have many friends of CRHS. May I begin with the former principal of Harold Knapper, Ms. Myra Kessler, and former principal, of Centennial, Ms. Carol Marriott. We also have Commissioner Mr. Chris Craig, whose son is one of our graduates here tonight. Among our guests are respected PPO members and governing board members. Please stand to be recognized. We also have, Ms. Christy Pokosh, former VP, and Mr. J.F. Labar, who welcome us today as well. And of course, last but not least, we cannot forget the generous individuals and groups, Legion Branch representatives, who, with their grand generosity, have encouraged our graduates with a donation of bursaries this evening. Thank you. At this time, I have the pleasure of introducing and inviting to the podium someone who has been a part of our school for many, many, many years. She is our strong leader and the greatest promoter of the burgundy and gold. In this, her last grad as acting principal, she of course, in true Miss Tite fashion, we practice, not crying too. In true Miss Tite fashion, she did not want it to be about her tonight. She said that tonight is about our graduates. She was the first voice you heard, graduates, in the auditorium 5 years ago on your first day of high school. And as she promised then, she is here to send you off on your last. Without further ado, please join me in giving an extra special welcome to our principal, Miss Sherry Tite.
Might be a few tears. Not that you're ever used to seeing Mrs. Tite in tears. Instead of the mean Mrs. Tite, you're going to get the emotional one tonight. You know, but it was all in good faith and made sure our students were here tonight. So now I'll get it over and done with. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Centennial Regional High School's class of 2020. 2023. This year's graduation is especially remarkable, not only because our students finished their 5 years at Centennial, but also they represent the 50th class to have graduated. It's hard to believe that our school has been open since 1972. Good job. We are in for an outstanding evening as we celebrate our students' completion of their high school career. What a journey it was. Thank you, Ms. Heron, for making me cry in front of my students, for that introduction and for being the master of ceremony. At this time, I would like to recognize and honor a remarkable group of individuals who have made this evening possible, all while working the thick of the school life. Without them, Centennial would not be as great as it is. This group is hardworking, determined, and dedicated to all the students and the graduating class. They have ensured this class has an outstanding graduation. This group of individuals need to be recognized and thanked for all they did to make this evening a special one. To my front office, Ms. Sove, Ms. Parsons, Ms. Blue, I'll get through it, I promise. Ms. Herbert, Ms. Seeley, and Ms. Annie Laufer, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. You are one terrific team, and you are definitely the best. Xantha, for always being there, no matter what I needed, whatever we needed, you jumped in. Thank you very much. To Patrick and Apollo, thank you for the last-minute technical support to ensure everything is perfect for tonight. Thank you, guys. To our centenaries for working behind the scenes, to Ms. Leslie Webb for guiding our valedictorians, and to our role leaders, thank you very much. To my administrative team. It's been a rough year for my administrative team. We started with Mr. Hunter, we had Ms. Sumani, and we have, still standing, Ms. Coons. But we were also very lucky that we had Madame Waugh, who jumped in to assist us many, many times. Thank you both very much. You made my life easier. To the yearbook staff, thank you for the time and effort you've devoted to providing our students with a yearbook to remember their time at Centennial. I would also like to thank the yearbook team for the very special pages dedicated to me. It will always hold a special spot in my heart. Thank you. Please give them a round of applause. Tonight, we also have one staff member who has decided that it is her time to graduate from Centennial after 26 years and to move on to the next stage of her journey, retirement. I ask that Mrs. Grace Brum DuPont please stand and be recognized for all her dedication to her students. Last, but definitely not least, the one person who takes on the challenge of organizing graduation each year. Each year, I say, you can't better the one from last year, but somehow, she does it. Jessie Heron is our activity officer who organizes graduation with pride, purpose, and commitment. She ensures that our graduates will be well taken care of and that there will be no issues. She ensures that you have the best possible grad. We couldn't do this without her. Please, please give her the biggest round of applause. Now to my graduates. Here we are tonight with family, friends, staff, and special guests to celebrate your graduation from high school. What a journey it has been. Today will be filled with mixed emotions as you bid farewell to the familiar hallways, friendships that you made, and the memories that were created. We must also acknowledge the extraordinary, once-in-a-lifetime, we hope, journey that you have survived and become a stronger individual, the COVID-19 pandemic. Your journey started when entering high school. You felt that this was going to be the biggest challenge. Little did we know what was coming. You worried about coming to a big school, not knowing many of your peers, scared you would get lost, and how you were going to survive those big, bad grade 11 students. Well, you are those grade 11 students now, and what a journey you have had. Grade 7, normal year, getting to know the school, making new friends, discovering your likes and dislikes, and all the activities you could join. But you couldn't have fathomed what was coming. Your journey was about to take a different path, a path that would allow you to discover what you were really made of. How would you face adversity, challenge yourself to move forward, and most importantly, how to survive? Grade 8 saw the closing of the school in March. A worldwide pandemic swept the globe. No aspect of your life was untouched. It brought fear, uncertainty, loneliness, and major disruptions. You wondered how you're going to make it, how you would survive. Your classroom in grade 9 became your home. You did everything in that one class. School as you knew it was gone. You came to school, you did your classes, you left at 4:05. Let's not forget, one day in, one day out. Masks, hand washing, mandatory. No extracurricular activities for anyone. No fun was had by anyone, staff or student. Yet we managed and overcame these obstacles. Moving on to grade 10, a better year, but still not normal. Activities came, they went, and they came back. Life was slowly getting back to normal. All this time, we witnessed the strength of our school, your community. The teachers, administrators, and staff worked tirelessly, ensuring that your education continued despite the obstacles. They adapted their teaching method, used technologies in ways they never thought of before, and were committed to your success. I please ask my staff to stand and be recognized for everything that you've done for our students. You guys changed your way of learning and developed strategies to survive not only in school, but in life. Now, here you sit, the graduating class of 2023. Not only did you survive the pandemic, but you have made your mark and are leaving Centennial with your heads held high, recognizing what you have accomplished. This graduating class has 201 members. Within this class, 69 students have made the Honor Society, being on the principal's honor roll every year for the 5 years. 5 students have made the Honor Society, the Associate Honor Society, being on the honor roll for the last 5 years at another school as well as Centennial. That is 36% of the grads. That's really outstanding. 44 students this year have made honors, and that's having a 90% or higher average in secondary 5, and that counts for 22% of the class. This one is, I'm very proud of you guys. 130 students have made the honor roll, 80% and above for term 1 and term 2. This means 65% of the class has made the honor roll. This is remarkable, seeing the turbulent journey you guys have had. You deserve a round of applause for this. students are graduating from the Francais Mother Tongue program. 23 students are graduating from the TAG Math Science program. 29 students are graduating from the TAG Liberal Arts program. And 3 students are graduating, my mouth is dry, from our pre-work program. Good job, everyone. Jessie mentioned the bursaries earlier. She didn't mention we received $17,000 in bursary money to help our students further their educations, and I'd love to thank all their donors for doing that. I know the students appreciate it. Also, PPO, I will thank you also because during pandemic and every year, no matter what, you never give up trying to raise money for the school and our students. Thank you very much for putting in all that time and effort. Grade 11, this was your best year. Once the restrictions were over, you brought life back into this building. Centennial, not this one, but Centennial. You took advantage of every opportunity given. You joined as many activities as you could, whether it was the Follies, senior play, sport teams, intramurals, the game room, Color Me Happy, you got involved. Country fair, entrepreneurial fair, back in full force. The grad trip to New York City, two buses full. What great memories you made with your classmates. You made the most of the time you had at Centennial, and you made up for lost time. Our journey in life is not always the way we planned, but we learn to move forward and discover who we are. You can adjust to anything in life has to throw. You can adjust to anything life has to throw at you. You survived a global pandemic. You have learned much about yourself over these last 5 years. You have learned to face your fears, compromise, and adapt. You have overcome so much and can leave Centennial knowing who you are and what you want to become. You will never be forgotten at CRHS. You are moving forward in the journey of life. Whether you continue your education or you're going out to the workforce, it's your choice. You know you can do it, and we believe you can. Let nothing stop you. Always know that you can give it your all, and with that, you can accomplish anything. Class of 2023, I want to congratulate each and every one of you for your accomplishments, perseverance, and strength you have shown during your time at Centennial. Remember your time at high school and the journey you had. The pandemic was only part of your journey. It doesn't define you, but it made you discover that you had more strength and courage than you thought. You are so much more than all the challenges you have faced. Today, celebrate not only your academic success, but watch as you move into adulthood. It has been a very difficult journey with many bumps along the way, but we are here tonight to celebrate your graduation. It is time to say goodbye. It is time to move on to the future and never let anyone tell you you can't do it, because you can. Look what have you lived through. You've lived through a pandemic. Now, all the opportunities are yours for the taking. Remember, we never know what will happen on our journey of life, but do not let the unknown stop you from becoming the best you can be. You have a long life ahead of you. Do not fear the future. Instead, allow the journey to happen and experience what it has to offer. Class of 2023, I wish you all the best. Future endeavors.
Thank you for the principal's address, Ms. Tite. Now we've arrived at the exciting and pride-filled part of this ceremony that is dedicated to the diploma presentations on stage. At this time, I will call upon teachers Ms. Jennifer Goodall and Mr. Greg Graham to please come to the podium and announce the names of the members of the 2023 graduating class.
Good evening. It is an honor for Mr. Graham and I to welcome our students on stage. I would like to remind you that all families want to hear their child's name being called, so please be respectful. Thank you. I now call upon Ms. Coons for the presentation of diplomas. Sumaya Alu Hamed, Associate Honor Society. Valerie Agostino, Honorable Mention, Francais. Alejandro Albarracin Gonzalez, Honorable Mention, Subject Prize in Biology, Associate Honor Society. Christina Alexandres, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, Français. Mohammed Al-Magrawi. Aveen Al-Tarawi. Finnegan Armstrong Craig, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, Subject Prize in History, CRHS Human Sciences Department Bursary. Gabriel Bashkanji, CRHS E-Fair Bursary. Emily Boddy, TAG Liberal Arts, Honorable Mention. Jasmine Begg, TAG Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Brittany Banville. Regan Barley. Justice Bascombe Frenette. Caleb Beals. Nathaniel Beaulieu Chow. Serena Bennett, CRHS Library Bursary. Avery Bernard Mightley, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, Subject Prize in Outdoor Education, Greenfield Park Borough Bursary, and the GPK Old Timers Bursary. Milena Berthlet, TAG Math Science, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Massimo Bilodeau.
Aiden James Bilovis. Olivia Blay, TAG Math Science, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, Francais, CRHS E-Fair Bursary. Sienna Blomendahl, Honor Society, Francais, Subject Prize in Visual Arts, CRHS Visual Arts Bursary. Jackie Bolap Calvong. Melina Bortnick. Madison Bosquet. Roman Bossa. Victoria Bradley. Diana Bretkowska. Andrew Burton Duluth. Rory Callender Adams. Danica Cambridge. Studio Nancy Bursary and CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Sarah Kaplan Boutet. TAG Liberal Arts, Francais, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Jasmine Chan, co-senior female athlete of the year, the Alex Lesserino Memorial Bursary and the Studio Nancy Bursary. Clayton Zinquan Chung. Awab Chaudhary, TAG Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Subject Prize in Financial Education, and Math Topics Gifted, RSB Bursary and EFAIR Bursary. Enya Clancy, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, Carol Marriott Make a Difference Award Bursary, Greenfield Park Old Timers Bursary, and the Lions Club of Greenfield Park Bursary. Alexandra Conganitis, TAG Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, the Ida and Bob Wright Memorial Bursary, and CRHS EFAIR Bursary. Lucas Conganitis. Selena Contos, TAG Liberal Arts.
Sarah Correa Rodriguez. Jillian Kasha, TAG Liberal Arts Honor Society. Aiden Cassette, TAG Math Science Honors Honor Society, RSB Parent Committee Bursary, CRHS EFAIR Bursary, and the Alex Lasserino Memorial Bursary. William Daigle. Lola Dequila, TAG Liberal Arts, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, CRHS PPO, Governing Board Bursary. Luca Dequila, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society. Mia Dequila, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, Subject Prize in Leadership and Drama, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary, CRHS Principals Bursary, and the CRHS Faculty Bursary. Adriana De Paz Perla, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society. Alisa Del Plesh. Lauren Demick. Rhea Dhaliwal, Honor Society, Studio Nancy Bursary. Kalilu Omar Diawara. Savannah Drakes. Dachiana Dumitrana. Jacob Duncan. Zachary Dunsmore. Callie Dussault. Hannah El Hussein, TAG Liberal Arts. Carter Elliott, Studio Nancy Bursary. Mateo Escano Bredur, honorable mention.
Zoe Ferrugia, Bag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Subject Prize in French Enriched, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Massimo Faulkner, Honor Society, Francais. Sienna Ferguson, Tag Liberal Arts, Honor Society. Justin Ferreira, Tag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary, and CRHS E-Fair Bursary. Rose Flajol, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Kimmy Fontaine, Honor Society, Francais, Co-Senior Math, Male Athlete of the Year, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary, CRHS Staff Basketball Bursary. Juliana Jem Foster. Allison Furtado. Lucy Gagnon, Tag Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Abdur Rahman Gangat. Yumna Gangat, Tag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Evangeline Garefa, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Sarah Gauvin, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, Royal Canadian Legion Branch 94 Bursary. Derica Geniosis Brousseau, Tag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Sharon Falana Leduc Citizenship Award Bursary, CRHS E-Fair Bursary, and the FSL Jean Cab Bursary. Eve Tetreault-Gingras, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, Francais. Léa Tetreault-Gingras, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, CRHS French Department Bursary, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary, and RSB Bursary. Kyla Gonzalez Diaz. Sophia Goodall, Honor Society, Francais, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Ella Grant, Tag Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS Tag Liberal Arts Bursary, Greenfield Park Borough Bursary, and the Greenfield Park Old Timers Bursary. Alexandra Gregoire.
Luca Grigoropoulos, Honor Society, Francais, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Jesse Mae Gilmain. Emma Hahn. Sean Harbour, honorable mention, Honor Society, Français, Riverside Teachers Union Bursary. George Harvey. Emily Rose Henderson in absentia. Christopher Hernandez Doplo, Tag Math Science, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary, CRHS eFair Bursary, and the CRHS Faculty Bursary. Joseph Hezarhani. Olivia Lopasco, Tag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, Subject Prize in Ethics and Religious Culture, CRHS Ethics and Religious Culture Bursary, and CRHS eFair Bursary. Danick Hogue Saint-Aubin, Subject Prize in French. Mateo Humphrey. Lillian Hurlett. Selena Imhoff. Laura Italiano, Tag Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary, and the RHA Memorial Science Bursary. Zachary Jackiemek LeClaire. Mikhail Jerbik, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, Francais. Jade Jette, Tag Liberal Arts, Honors, Subject Prize in Leadership and Drama, CRHS Performing Arts Bursary. Devin Jewell. Issa Jolie. Isai Jones Wapaya.
Mike Jr. Joseph. Roshan Kangarani Farahani. CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Emilio Casamatis, Honorable Mention, Francais, Subject Prize in Physical Education and Health. Faizan Khalid. Daniel Khan, Tag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Studio Nancy Bursary. Adam Kleefeld. Anastasios Kredis, Francais, Associate Honor Society. Océane Landry. Brianna Langlois Vero. Olivier Laperle, Français. Ryan Lau, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, Francais. Luca Lavaretto. Alicia Legrand, Panacea Bursary. Jaden LaWarn. Carla Lentz, Honors, Subject Prize in World Geography. Brendan Lockhin Lung, Honors, Associate Honors Society, Francais, Subject Prizes in Chemistry and Physics, Education Financiere and Mode Contemporain, Math 5 Science Option, CRHS Math Department Bursary, and Science Department Bursary. Roy Leung. Sarah Levac, CRHS eFair Bursary. Chloe Levesque, TAG Math Science, CRHS eFair Bursary, and Greenfield Park Old Timers Bursary. Akil Lindor.
Ethan McKenzie Montpetit. Sophia Anna Major, Honor Society. Damien Mack, Honor Society, Francais, Studio Nancy Bursary, and CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. William Mallow, CRHS WOTP Bursary. Malachi Malumbres, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS Drama Bursary, CRHS Principals Bursary, and CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Mark Francis Manansala, TAG Math Science, Honorable Mention. Liam Manthri Ratna, Honor Society. Mackenzie Martineau. Carly Martin Sargent, CRHS WOTP Bursary. Neve McGreevy, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Aiden Moore. Kalina Morrison. Layla Morsi. Benjamin Moss, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, CRHS Performing Arts Bursary, and the CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Isra Mughal. Alea Mergi, TAG Liberal Arts, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, Francais, Co-Senior Female Athlete of the Year, Staff Basketball Bursary, and GPK Old Timers Bursary. Sean Nabizada, Tag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Subject Prize in English and Math Topics Gifted, CRHS eFair Bursary, and the Accra Riverside Administration Association Bursary. Elizabeth Nagy, Honor Society, Français. Nathan Noransing.
Gabrielle Nunes Marchin, Honorable Mention, Associate Honor Society. Ella Olivia Oliverio, Tag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, Subject Prize in Science, Technology, and Society, RSB Bursary, and CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Bilal Mantadar Warji. Stavrula Panaridis, Riverside Teachers Union Bursary. Vanessa Parker. Victoria Parker. William Parker. Levi Pascal Mutanda. Adam Pelchet, Tag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Francais. Dominic Peng, Tag Liberal Arts. Jacob Petrusich, CRHS Administrator's Choice for Perseverance and Determination. Austin Picado, Subject Prize in Physical Activity for Life. Marcus Poirier. Noah P. Coller. Ray Annika Pretty, Francais. Matisse Plou Standish, Tag Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, Subject Prize in Physical Education and Health, Royal Canadian Legion Branch 94 Bursary. Matthew Spencer Ricci. Jayla Rock, Honor Society, Fonds 1804 Bursary, and the CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Claire Romanchuk, Tag Math Science, Honor Society, Francais, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Akersh Sani, Honors Society, Francais, Subject Prize in Drama, CRHS Administrator's Choice Bursary, and the Alex Lesserino Memorial Bursary.
Conrad Lucas Schober. Andy Seguin, Tag Liberal Arts, Honorable Mention, Honor Society. Massimo Sforza. Zoe Silber, Francais. Hope Smith, CRHS WOTP Bursary. Tirin Shanan St. Cyr Innes, Honorable Mention, Francais. Nathan St. Jean, Honors. Nicholas St. Maurice Pearson. Eric St. Eve. William Tardif, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, CRHS TAG Liberal Arts Bursary. Jeff Chatterjan, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, Co-Senior Male Athlete of the Year, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary, and the Alex Lazzarino Memorial Bursary. Lillian Templeton, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, Subject Prize in Music, RSB Parent Committee, CRHS Music Department Bursary, and the Greenfield Park Borough Bursary. Christian Toller Lori, in absentia. Kayla Tom, TAG Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary, and the JAA Memorial Science Bursary. Maeve Tom, TAG Math Science, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, Subject Prize in Science, Technology, and Society, CRHS TAG Math and Science Bursary, and CRHS eFair Bursary, and Champlain College Scholarship. Annabelle Toupin. Jake Tremblay, Honors. Olivia Tremblay. Eleni Tsotrudis, Honor Society, Francais.
Jasmine Sky Valentini Baller, TAG Liberal Arts, Honor Society. Connor Velli. Sierra Vezina, TAG Liberal Arts, Honorable Mention, Honor Society, Francais, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Amanda Vicente Pereira, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Subject Prize in Visual Arts. Kaylin Pui Ching Wang, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Rashad Walcott. Chloe Walsh, Honors, Honor Society, Subject Prize in Home Economics and Math, Cultural, Social, and Technical Option, the Morneau Meisner Bursary, and the TVRS Bursary. Reese Warren. Lara Wasti, TAG Liberal Arts, Honors, Honor Society, Francais, Subject Prize in English, Francais and Issues, Ideas and Culture, Liberal Arts, RSB High Academic Bursary, RSB Commissioner's Humanitarian Award Bursary. Sophia Wei, Honorable Mention, CRHS PPO Governing Board Bursary. Victoria Wilson. Emily Jane Weingart Abran, in absentia. Solomia Javorska. Yu King Zhang, Associate Honors Society. Congratulations, grads.
Thank you. Wait, 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 wait. You're ahead of the game. Eager Beavers. Thank you, Mrs. Goodall and Mr. Graham. Honored guests, families of the graduates, on behalf of Centennial Regional High School, it is my honor to present to you the graduating class of 2023. Good job, guys. Now, I would like to present our special awards. Our first award is the Students' Choice Award. These awards were voted on by you, the members of the graduating class, to honor the outstanding leadership qualities of your peers. I call on Mr. Dan Lamoureux, Chair of the Council of Commissioners for the Riverside School Board, to make these medal presentations. The Student's Choice Bronze Medal goes to Enya Clancy. Guys, please. The Student's Choice Silver Medal goes to Benjamin Moss. It's okay. And the Student's Choice Gold Medal goes to Baptiste Prou Standish. Congratulations to our three winners, and thank you, Mr. Lamoureux. Yep. Our next presentation is the Students' Life and Leadership Award. This award is for the student who has taken an active leadership role in the student life throughout their high school career. I call upon the one and only Jesse Heron to make this presentation. The Centennial Regional High School Students Life and Leadership Award goes to Malachi Melambres. Congratulations, Malachi, and thanks, Jess. I now call upon, she doesn't know I'm doing this, but I'm doing it anyways, Madame St. Cyr, our Department Coordinator for the Arts, to please come make the next presentation. I got busy and I couldn't find you, sorry. We have a new award this year. It's called the Darrell Stevens Perseverance and Triumph Award. This award is given to the graduating student who has demonstrated that no matter what life throws at them, they are able to overcome any obstacle. With hard work and determination, they can do anything. Darrell has had a very successful career and has never let his past stop him. He wanted to give back to his community, his school, and this award comes with a $2,000 bursary. The big one. Yep. The graduate chosen for this award has had much in the past 5 years. This student was quiet, individual who worked very hard and put in the time needed to do well academically, as well as participating in student life. The student wanted to achieve a well-balanced life. Then the pandemic hit. This student needed to go to the virtual school, as there were many health issues in the family, and they couldn't risk bringing home any viruses. During this time, this graduate made the decision not to go out with friends for almost 2 years in order to protect her family. Art became her best friend. She loves art, and her drawings are incredible, and you can see her artwork in our agenda. Yearbook. Once the pandemic subsided, the student returned to school and once again needed to work extremely hard. This year, the student maintained an average of 94%. Excellent. She is off to Dawson in the Fine Arts program, and we wish her all the luck. The winner of the Darrell Stevens Perseverance and Triumph Award is Chloe Walsh. Thank you, Ms. St. Cyr. Congratulations, Chloe. I now call upon Madame Lucy Waugh, the Director General of the Riverside School Board, to present the awards honoring our top three students. The difference between first and third place academically was 0.925. The difference between second and third place was 0.625. And the difference between first and second place was 0.3. A close race between our top three graduates. They should be very proud of themselves. The road to graduation is not an easy one, especially given the events of these last 3 years. The bronze medal is awarded to the student who achieves the third highest academic standing in the graduating class based on last year's provincial results and the first two terms of this year. We are very pleased to present this award to the student with an overall average, 96.3%. Congratulations, Leah Vingra. The silver medal is awarded to the student who achieves the second highest academic standing in the graduating year based on last year's provincials and the first two terms of this year. We are very pleased to present this award to the student with an overall average of 96.925. Congratulations, Awab Chowdhury. Riverside School Board Highest Achievement Gold Medal and the Centennial Regional High School Scholar of the Year plaques, plus the Governor General Award, is awarded to the student who achieves the highest academic standing in the graduating class. The awarded student came to the doors of Centennial and started off in grade 7 with an average of 92.34. This student was in Francais. Their lowest mark in grade 7 was an 87%. Not bad for the first year of high school. Grade 8, as we know, brought a whole bunch of new challenges. First, the student was selected into a join our TAG liberal arts program. The student started off very strong, then the pandemic hit. The school was closed for the last 3 months. Term 1 and 2, the majority of their marks were in the 90s. At the end of the year, their average was a pass. No percentages were given out at the end of the year due to the pandemic, but I guess you all guessed, she passed all the classes. Big surprise. Grade 9 introduced bubble classes. Students were in the same class all day, even at lunch, as the pandemic was in full force. There's no extracurricular activities in school one day and out the next. When school ended at 9:05, the building was emptied. However, this did not stop them. Their marks ranged between 93 and 99, with a little blip along the way with an 87. I am very proud of this student, and I'm sure her parents are. Their average in grade 9 was 96.15%, outstanding for a turbulent year. Grade 10, life in school is getting back to normal, while almost activities were on and off. This student participated in public speaking, basketball, track and field. For their academics, they were in Francais, high science, math option, science. This student had 27 100s during the 3 terms and maintained an average of 97.4 for the year. A great comeback after COVID. Now in grade 11, back to normal school, the student was in chemistry, physics, science option math, Francais was in the TAG liberal arts program. His student participated in basketball, public speaking, slam poetry, was part of social justice club, and a centenaire. This is truly a well-rounded student. Academically, this student's marks range from an 89 in Francais to a 99 in English, art, science, and social sciences as well. This student has 8 100s for the first 2 terms, and I can't wait to see what her final term looks like at Centennial. I know it'll be outstanding with an overall average for the first 2 terms of 96%. This student was inducted into the Centennial Regional High School Honor Society tonight, as well as will be receiving the Governor General's Medal. Family, friends, special guests, and staff at Centennial, it is my honor to name this year's recipient of the Centennial Regional High School Scholar of the Year, as well as the Riverside School Board Gold Medal, based on an average of 97.225 from last year's provincials and the first 2 terms this year. Ladies and gentlemen, our winner is Lara Westy. It is now my pleasure to introduce the valedictorians for the class of 2023, both outstanding members of our student body. Maya Dekila and Malachi Lamembrez, please come up.
So guys, we have an issue. I forgot our speech in the limo.
Did you check everywhere?
Yeah, I looked all over the place, and besides, we can't keep everyone waiting.
Malachi, I've been covering for you for 5 years. I kind of knew this was going to happen, so I brought extras. Good evening, faculty, support staff, administration, family, friends, and class of 2023. First off, I have to say, wow, Malachi, we get to share the stage one last time.
I might shed a tear.
You'll be okay. We are honored to be here representing Centennial as we close this chapter of our lives. Thank you to the platform party for sharing the stage with us. And thank you all for being with us on this special night.
Speaking of special, I would like to thank some very special people in my life, my parents, and both my sisters.
And to my siblings, Luca and Lola, I'm so lucky to have experienced these past 5 years with you both by my side, every day, in every class.
To my sisters, Yvette and Winona, I'm clearly better than you since you guys weren't valedictorians. My bad, the stage is yours.
I'd like to thank my parents for teaching me to follow my passions. Thank you to all the families that are with us tonight for your endless support and encouragement. And to the staff of Centennial, thank you for all the love, whether it was sweet,
Ms. Joyce,
or tough love,
Ms. Joyce.
It was impactful. Because of you, we've come so far in the last 5 years.
Coming from rough beginnings in the Philippines, moving to the slums of Brassard, to being cast as Gaston in the senior play.
Enough about you. Don't I look good? Hair done, nails done. It only took about 4 hours.
It's not about you right now either, Mia. You're not the main character.
Aren't we all main characters in our own stories?
You're right. A main character moment is like Sean begging on his knees, asking women to date him during his persuasive speech.
Or Andrew dropping future Billboard songs.
Maybe it's Ben singing like an angel on stage.
Miss Tite leading this school for who knows how long. Since the biblical era, maybe.
The senior basketball teams bringing home banners.
Lucy the lunch monitor giving everyone gum.
Miss Rosenoff making us all laugh in her charger chuckles.
Xantha being Xantha.
Is it Mr. Jacob having his own cheer? Ronnie, Ronnie, Ronnie.
You're right. You are all main characters in your own stories.
Whether you'd like to believe us or not, you have achieved greatness here at Centennial.
I ask you to think back on your high school experience. What were your main character moments? How did your story begin?
Let me take you all back to secondary one, the start of your chapter. The year was 2018. Astroworld was taking over our playlist. It was a soundtrack to our lives. The hit song Sicko Mode was all over the place, just like we were in Sec 1.
This chapter of our lives was confusing. We all came into our first year of high school nervous. We were worried about fitting in, and we thought we'd cry over homework every night. We feared the older kids and crushed on them. But most importantly, everyone wore checkered slip-on Vans.
At the start of a story, main characters are often seen anticipating one significant moment. This moment is essential for character development. It is like Spider-Man getting bitten by a spider, and for the boomers in the crowd, it is like Jack meeting Rose in Titanic.
The start of your story could be meeting a new friend in your core class. It could be getting into a sport or simply trying to fit into the high school ambiance. Secondary one taught us that it is okay to be unsure of yourself, that every main character faces self-doubt on their journey to success.
Secondary 2 tick dated the end of chapter 1 and the beginning of senior year in middle school. The Raptors just won the championship. I wore Kappa tracksuits. Mio was a VSCO girl. TikTok was at its peak. Life was good.
Until it wasn't. All main characters face adversity, and COVID-19 was our greatest challenge yet. We thought we were getting a 2-week vacation. Boy, were we wrong. That vacation turned into isolation. We didn't get to say goodbye to our friends. We watched every single thing Netflix had to offer. We witnessed our class fail miserably at becoming TikTok famous.
Damian Mack, we're looking at you.
We were all victims of circumstance. Even though we were all divided, we still bonded over the hardships of COVID. Unfortunately, those hardships continued into secondary 3.
We did not expect our secondary 3 year to consist of Mr. Bobby having a full Rocky Balboa workout while we slept in his class.
Sorry, Mr. Bobby. This part of our story was a filler chapter. Some would say a fever dream. Every main character faces a few chaotic plot points to keep them on their toes.
It consisted of VSCO girls turning into indie girls.
Boys going from Adidas tracksuits to dressing like skater boys.
We were in school half the time and out of school for the other half. We all felt unsafe and decided to leave school for a walkout.
Maybe that was the year Miss Tite contemplated retirement. During secondary 4, our story led to more trials and tribulations. People clearly didn't know how to act after not seeing each other for 2 years. We finally saw people's faces and, I can't lie, I was surprised.
Life started to feel real again. We defeated the supervillain known as Secondary 4. Thanks to sports, school productions, and school field trips, returning to life brought us ease.
That year was important for character development. We learned much about adjusting to a life we were once comfortable with. This led to the last stretch.
Let's set the scene. Ice Spice becomes popular and hopefully will one day become my wife. Drake drops her loss and Miss Joyce drops Disney villains in prison.
The grad dance brings out Rihanna's halftime show and Mr. Tam saves us from getting mugged in New York City.
These experiences have taught us many things. They have taught us to celebrate our wins and learn from our losses.
They have taught us to be honest with ourselves and by extension, be honest with others. A suede suit for grad? You're not Bruno Mars.
A black dress? Is this a funeral? Being honest with ourselves means accepting that failure is a necessary part of progress.
We are going to get lost in the metro. Maybe some of us will face a quarter-life crisis when we realize we chose a program that isn't for us. We might end up switching professions, and let's be honest, we're going to fall in love with the wrong people.
But if they're hot, why not?
Your high school experience will not be defined by your popularity, but by your relationships, by the kind of person you were. Your main character moment is about being conscious of the paths you cross.
As much as you are the main character in your story, you're a supporting character in someone else's narrative. I ask you to reflect on the legacy you leave behind, both in your story and as well as others.
Our high school chapters may be behind us, but we are always the authors to our own stories. There are many more chapters to be written, more characters to be discovered, and more memories to be made. But enough about the future. Let's take this time to focus on the present and celebrate our accomplishments.
I made it. I graduated with the fear of women and a tree nut allergy.
I made it. I graduated knowing my therapist knows most of your names.
We laughed together. We raised flower babies together. And tonight, we're going to party together.
So collectively, we should end this speech together.
Like the main characters that we are. And we have to include Miss Tite because she's graduating with us together. From the great philosopher, and street poet Aubrey Graham, better known as Drake.
On three, I want everyone to scream at the top of their lungs and say, "We made it."
One, two, three. We made it! Congratulations, class of 2023. Thank you.
Thank you, Mia and Malachi, for the valedictorian presentation this evening. You were exceptional, and you have made your fellow graduates very proud. We've waited a long time for today's ceremonies, and now it's almost time to say goodbye. But before we part, I must mention a few reminders. Our graduation ceremony will be followed by the banquet. I remind all grads to return their gowns following the ceremony to the same room that you lined up in. Also, outside, there's going to be a photo booth set up for you to enjoy. There's just one final thought, which is an extremely important reminder. Please, and we cannot possibly emphasize this enough, celebrate responsibly tonight. Party, have fun, but surround yourself with people and friends who care about you. Be safe so that you can cherish the memories that you make tonight. Now, it is time to conclude tonight's ceremonies. In a few minutes, almost done. In a few minutes, the recession music will start, and as the graduation recession takes place, I would kindly ask the audience to please remain at your seats and allow the platform party, followed by the faculty, and finally by the graduates to exit the hall. So faculty, you'll just walk across in front of the stage and we'll exit that door.
Aww. Thank
you. Congratulations. And with that, may I say that you have been a fantastic audience. We'll see you again. Thank you.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. And it's so hard to say goodbye. But yesterday's gone, we gotta keep moving.
Goodbye. Yesterday's gone. It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Damn, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through. Then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I see you again.
We've come a long way,
yeah, we came a long way
from where we began.
You know we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I tell you
when I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong. And what's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond. And that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn. And that line is what we reach, so remember me when I'm gone. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way, yeah. Hold every memory as you go, and every road you take.